Is your company on the fence about whether to use Microsoft 365 Copilot? Well, if you're an Excel user, this is one file I would show the decision makers on why you need Copilot. This is a great Copilot exercise. I have a list of classes that our employees have attended in column B. If you notice, for example, Excel is sitting in cell B2 as the second one, but in cell B3, it is listed as the third one for whatever that employee's name is. What I'm trying to figure out are what classes have the employees attended, and I want to do that with either a yes or a no, but I also need all those classes listed across the top, starting in cell C1, going over to the right to wherever they stop, and I actually don't know. Let's see if Copilot can figure this out. I'm going to click in my data. No big deal here, but I'm not using a table. I'm just using a range, which is a new feature. I'm going to select Copilot. And I've already written this prompt just so you don't have to watch me do this. The prompt says, take the training class column and separate the classes in separate yes-no columns where there is a semicolon, and I even put what the semicolon looks like. I don't know if that was required, but that's what I put in my prompt. Be specific about your prompts. Now, the delimiter for me is a semicolon, but it could be any delimiter. It doesn't have to be a semicolon in case you're going to have that question later. Let's run this or send it off. Copilot should, after looking at my data, come back with multiple Excel functions. It's going to use an if function. I can already tell it because that's what I would use to figure this out. But it's going to hopefully have multiple Excel functions because there's multiple classes. Let's scroll to the top and let's see what Copilot returned with. There's my prompt in the green background box. And then, and I'm not going to sit here and read every bit of this, but it says, okay, I went to A1 to B12, and it said it's going to insert columns in column C through H. It's going to have a column for Word. And look at that if function that it's using. I could hit show explanation to see exactly what it's doing. I'm not going to continue going through here, but Excel is next. That looks good. I'm down at the bottom. There's my preview. I'm going to select insert columns. So we have six different classes that our employees took, going from Word all the way over to Microsoft Forms. Everything is either a yes or a no. Let me just check something real quick. I'm going to check Microsoft Forms because I just got a bunch of no's in here with just a few yeses. Row 7's got a yes and row 9 has a yes. Just to quickly see if that's right, I like to check my data. Let's do text that contains forms and hit OK. So the two yeses in column H is correct. I'm going to undo and turn off the conditional formatting. Great, great feature of Copilot. It actually did multiple columns at one time with fairly advanced Excel functions. That was a nested if function it did for each one of these. I appreciate your time. My Copilot online training is available down below, along with Teams, Excel, OneNote. Have a great day.